Any questions?
Congratulations on a big win in unifying the title and taking them back to Omaha, Nebraska. There's not enough words in anyone's dictionary to describe the performance that you displayed tonight. But I want to ask you, why did you choose to fight in southpaw when you're capable of fighting him both ways? And when you did fight him, you were moving to your left quite a bit as a southpaw. Could you tell us what was in your mind as you were going through that?
Well, I wanted him to throw his right hand, but he wouldn't throw it. I was going to counter his right hand. I already took the jab away from him in a southpaw stance. And we was just patiently waiting. Every time he threw his right hand, I counter him. So we was just waiting.
I also hear that Warren Buffett is one of your big supporters in Omaha, Nebraska. How often have you gotten that voice from him?
Well, not too often. He's a big supporter, but everybody know Warren Buffett is behind doors. So, you know, I had the pleasure of going to his office and sitting there and chat for him about an hour and a half. And, you know, people would pay thousands of dollars just to sit with him for 5 minutes. So it was a pleasure. He's a cool guy.
Terrence. How you doing? Congratulations tonight.
Thanks.
How does it make you feel to see that hundreds, possibly thousands of people from Omaha made the trip here despite numerous cancellations, driving 18 hours, and to all those people back in Omaha? What do you want to say to those fans tonight?
I love y'all. I love y'all. It's not every day that they get to see a world championship fight, let alone one of their own. You know, it's a lot of people that couldn't make it today because of the Southwest little thing that was going on and canceled thousands of flights. I don't know what happened with Southwest, but I appreciate the people that was going out their way to drive to Des Moines, to Denver, to Kansas City to make sure they came and see me fight. So I love them for that.
Right here. I have to say, you reminded me tonight of Floyd Mayweather, the way you moved around the ring and, you know, stuck and moved. And is that something, I mean, have you studied him at all, you know, the way he fights?
Well, who haven't watched Floyd? You know, Floyd was, still is one of the guys that I look up to as a fighter and not only in the ring, but the things he do in the ring as well. But I just boxed today. You know, I said all week I was gonna have fun in there, and I believe I did have fun in there. And everybody was talking about Victor's jab and how tall he is and what he was gonna do. But what happened?
Did you go by the game plan the whole way?
I just had fun. I beat myself in there. You know, I didn't do nothing I didn't have to do. I could have pressed on the gas, but why? You know, he was frustrated. He couldn't do nothing with my movement. I had him figured out from round three on.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Shout out to my sparring partner, Maurice Hooker. He pushed me to the limit. When I say he pushed me to the limit, man, that guy right there, man, thank you, man. It's a blessing. Be cool with you, man.
Thank you.
For real. For real. He the next one, man. It was days in camp where I was tired. He'd be like, come on, champ. Come on. I believe in you. And he'd push me. He'd push me, like, really push me to the limit. And it'd be like, man, like, coming to the corner, like, tired. Like, come on, champ. Like, man, I go back out here and do it. Man, I appreciate it, man. All love, baby. All love.
Terrence, congratulations, of course. My question was to Brian Bomack. Brian.
Hey, right there.
Brian, heading into the fight, a lot of people thought it'd be a close fight, toughest fight of Terrence's career. You told anyone who would listen that it wouldn't be close, and that when the fight really went underway and the exchanges began, Postal would retreat and Terrence would bite down. How validated do you feel tonight?
Man, I'm so excited. I can't even say nothing. I just want to say, next time y'all gonna believe me. I knew he was gonna take over the fight. He did exactly what we wanted him to do. I just got one thing to say. They said we was in over our heads, so. Right. Freddie who? All right, then.
Terrence?
Sorry.
Terrence?
Yeah.
This is a question for Terrence and Bob. Does this victory open the doors to a fight with Manny Pacquiao?
Press conferences are for the fighters, and the fighters will answer the questions. I'm no longer going to perform for you guys.
Who's on my radar? I don't have a radar. You know, I always looked at myself as a top athlete, and they come after me, I don't go after them because I'm where they want to be.
So Terrence, in Victor Postol's post-fight, he said he felt he was the one pushing to make the fight, but I noticed something in the 12th round, you were showing your showmanship and you were actually fighting more risky than you had to. So what was going on in your mind in the 12th round when you were making a dogfight when you were clearly up?
Well, he said he wanted to fight. He told me, let's go, you know, and I smiled at him and I stepped forward and he retreated and started running. So I was like, I thought we was going to fight it out. You know, I never ran from a fight before. We knew he wasn't going to exchange with me. His thing was to try to get me to come in and counter me. He really didn't want to fight. You know, the whole time that he was coming forward and all that, when I stepped to him, he'd jump back. So that lets me know everything right there.
Terrence, over here. First off, congratulations again.
Thanks.
How do you celebrate your win?
Just chill out. You know, I got my family over there. I got so many fans that came out here to support me. I'm just gonna chill out and enjoy my victory and just relax.
Terrence, right here in the middle. I saw you react when you knocked him down with a check left hook. What was said in the middle of that round? And part two, do you think you need to be more boisterous so the casual fans can truly appreciate your greatness?
Well, when I knocked him down, it wasn't nothing. I wasn't going to rush anything. But far as voicing, I don't need to do that. You know, that's not me. I've been getting to where I am now by winning. And at the end of the day, you can say what you want. But if you ain't winning, it doesn't matter.
Hey, Terrence, congratulations on a great performance. First question, how did you feel in the first four rounds? It looked like you was trying to fill them out. And also, how does it feel to be considered pound for pound top three, one of the best fighters in the world by a lot of different fans?
I feel
in
good.
The world, I should say.
I feel good. The top three rounds, I felt like I was doing everything I wanted to do. I was frustrating him. Took away his jab. The movement was killing him. And he was in for a long night.
Any other cash questions? Hey, Omaha people.
Yeah.
Enjoy Las Vegas. We got great nightclubs. Any place you go, and there are a lot of people, and you can't get in, just tell them you're with Terrence, and you get right in.
Congratulations to everybody. Thank you. And I want to thank the MGM for being terrific hosts. Thank you.